don't seem like long enough. Start prioritizing time alone with God in your daily life. The scripture says, after telling everyone goodbye, he went up into the hills by himself to pray. Jesus led by example, by prioritizing time alone with God, and so should you. Comment amen if you receive this message.
If you are going through a hard time, I want you to listen to this. Sometimes you have to be knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand taller than you ever have.
Having an off day or feel anxious, listen to this affirmation. I had a very anxious and low morning yesterday. I met up with a friend and she shared this with me. It changed my entire day around. Also, if you are having a hard day, just know that it's okay. It will pass. Feel those feelings, process, meet up with a friend, say this to yourself, and I think you'll feel better. Say this affirmation. Show me how good it can get. I love this because putting out that energy into the world to give you the gift, to give you the gifts that you deserve is so amazing to think about. Show me how good it can get. In every situation today, if you come in with an open mind, if you put your energy out there, if you trust the process, this is what I did yesterday and this morning, and it's really helped me have an amazing morning and day. Sending you all a ton of love.
Allah will bring about, after every hardship, ease. Ease to our mind, ease to our hearts. What a soothing reminder and promise. The assurance that we all need. When you're going through a hard time, what do you want to hear? That things are going to get better, right? For those of you who had me sign your book, many times I would write a short when I was ill. Better days will come. You are loved. Your best days are still ahead. I want to encourage you to not give up. Even though the current situation you're in may seem bleak, gloomy, dark, I want to encourage you to have higher hopes.
Don't be so sad. I know it's hard sometimes. Stop and take a deep breath. I promise it'll be okay. I love you.
Chen, I feel depressed. I have times when I feel really depressed too. Even last night, I had a lot of thoughts. Like right before I slept. I slept at like 4 or 5 yesterday night. But then I got in bed at like 1 or 2, but then I don't know, I was like thinking about this and that, I was thinking about so many stuff, and then in the end I slept really late. But then, as you guys know as well, the more you think about just this and that, it just, you know, connects to each other, and then it just keeps going to like negative thoughts. But just know that, you know, I have times where I feel depressed too, so just know that you're not the only one, and I hope that helps. It probably won't help at all, but I guess I'm trying to help, but I am always here to try my best to help you not get depressed, so I hope that helps out.
It's okay. Hey, you want to see something? Look up. Look. Look at that. It's incredible, isn't it? All those colors. Don't worry about anything else. I'll be right here with you. It's okay. It's okay.
A lot of you online hearing me right now who are under witchcraft attack, would the dreams are going to be the evidence of all of this. Dreaming about cats, or you dream someone who is always standing in a dream staring at you. All of this represents monitoring spirits. You're always dreaming about the sea or bodies of water, or you dream where you're underwater and you literally could still function as if you're some kind of fish or whatever. All of this is showing that there's the marine spirits, you're under marine curses. All of this is revealing to you, if you're dreaming about you're always in the forest, or you see trees and stuff behaving like humans or acting like humans towards you in a dream in a negative way, then the dream is revealing that the curses that are upon you, that branch of witchcraft, is witchcraft from the forest, where they're going in the forest and there's certain trees that they have as altars with your personal effects, your pictures, your underwear, your pieces of hair, where they're now putting it on that altar and repeating chants and doing ceremonies, all of this to bring those spirits in legally to now project at you. But if you don't know these things, you're going to dismiss. I had this foolish dream last night where I saw these dogs coming after me. What does dog represent in the dream? Dogs represent evil spirits. For the most part, they represent lustful spirits. You got to look at the type of dog, because the type of dog will determine the rank of the demonic force that's against you. For example, you may just have a dream about a puppy. It's speaking of a tormenting spirit.
Today's positive quote: blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in him.
Yes, I'm talking about firm belief, right? I'm talking about the good news is God will never let us down. I'm talking about firm belief. If God say he's a healer, he is a healer, right? If God say he will deliver us, he will deliver us. If God say he will turn things around for the good, he gonna do that, right? I'm talking about firm belief, right? Blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord. I'm talking, happy is the one who trusts in the Lord, right? He's never gonna let us down, right? So we gotta believe God in the midst of everything that we're going through, right? You need a healing? Believe God, right? See, what happens is we want things to happen. We want to happen. And when it don't happen, right, we don't realize, you know what I mean? We start to swear away from believing God. But hold on to your faith. Hold on to your confidence, right? Trust in God in everything that you're going through, right? And as always, believe in it, pray about it,
and work at it.
God is superb.
The algorithm of God is found, you, beloved. Let's chop it up real quick. So, beloved, let's talk about celebration. One of the greatest things that you can do to usher in your blessing, to usher in your breakthrough, to make room for your blessing and your breakthrough, is to celebrate somebody else when they get their breakthrough. Celebrate somebody else when they get married, when they have a baby, when they get into a healthy, happy, whole relationship. Because when you put that energy out there of celebrating and being grateful and thankful for somebody else's happiness and joy and peace, that comes back to you emotionally, mentally, and spiritually. It also keeps you from going into a slump of low self-esteem, or why is it happening for me, depression, sadness, or jealousy. It cuts all those feelings and emotions out and gives the enemy no place in your heart and mind, because when you can celebrate somebody else, you're decreeing and declaring and proclaiming that God can do it for me too. If God did it for them, he can do it for me too, because let me remind you of the word. God is no respecter of persons. He will do the same thing for you, beloved, that he did for the next person. You got to remember, beloved, that God is always going to give you a prequel to what's coming for you. So whatever you're around, whatever you're experiencing, whatever you're seeing happen for other people, that means you up next, boo. You up next. Just in case you were wondering when it's going to happen for you, if you are seeing a lot of people around you getting married or getting into relationships or their job taking off, their business taking off, or whatever the case may be, boo, you up next. God will always surround you with the blessing, with the miracle that he's getting ready to bring into your life, so you can start preparing, because it's getting ready to come to your doorstep and ring your doorbell next. So, beloved, if you're in a place of why not me and when is it going to happen for me, I want you to shift, realign, and readjust yourself to saying, you know what, it's my turn. I'm up next. I'm seeing this. I celebrate them. I'm so happy for them because it's coming to me next. So shift your focus, beloved, because it's your time and it's your turn. You up next, boo. Love you.
Hey, family, good morning. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for a brand new day. We thank you for your love and your mercies and your grace. Father, there are many people who are watching now who have been doubting themselves lately. They have been bombarded with lots of questions, wondering, are they really going to accomplish what they set out to do? I pray in the name of Jesus, all doubts be gone right now. I cancel all distractions from your mind and from your soul, and I speak peace. I declare in the name of Jesus, you know that the God who created the whole world, the God of the universe, he's got your back, and he's perfecting everything that concerns you. It shall be done. Not just that it shall be done, it's already done. I pray your faith be revived. I pray your praise be revived. It is done. It will be done, and it shall be done in the name of Jesus Christ.
You guys ever heard that saying that God gives his hardest battles to his strongest warriors? Yeah. The reason why that is even said is because of the fact that when you have a gift within you, you have a power within you, and it is a big one. I'm talking impactful. You're going to really, really do something that you never probably even thought that you could achieve. There's going to be things that are going to happen, okay? That is just the enemy trying to work against you because it knows where you're headed, knows the successes that you desire, and knows where you're going. So we cannot allow for the enemy to win. And how you do not allow him to win is that you stay focused, you stay consistent, you remember what makes you happy, because that is the important place. That's why this world is so focused on things that do not make us happy, because they think that that's the answer. And that's not the answer. The answer will always lie in what you are satisfied with. So if something does not make you satisfied, change it.
God has a message that he has wanted me to release to some of his people. But before you continue to watch this prophetic word, please pray to God and test the spirit to see if this word is for you before you continue to watch this video. But God blessed me with a word this morning regarding some of you guys. And what God said was, you can see that nothing can stop you now. You can see what I see, my son, my daughter. You see yourself as a reflection of I, your heavenly Father, now. You see yourself as the anointed one you are now. You see the power you hold. Your inward shines brighter than your outward. And you now perceive that you... And you now perceive that with nothing but clear vision. The devil didn't want this, but he had to sit and watch. He didn't want you to see that you are more powerful than him. For my spirit is within you. Remain humble and continue to walk in your identity, my son, my daughter. So God is saying to some of you, right, that in this time you have actually, you know, completely seen who you are in Christ, like completely, like God has ensured that you are able to see yourself the way he sees you, and as well as that, see you're able to see, you know, the spiritual vision that you had of yourself. And I mentioned this in the word yesterday that I released, and I think it was the first word that I released, and it's got two parts. I might add it to the playlist if it is the right one that I'm speaking about. I'll like add this prophetic word to the playlist that one like is obviously part of, but so you can watch that one as well. But God is saying to some of you, right, that you're actually like seeing yourself the way God sees you now. Like, you have done the work, right? You've done the work in the secret place with God, and you can now see yourself the way God sees you. And God just wants you to know that the devil didn't want you to be able to see yourself the way God sees you, but now he's gonna have to deal with it, because he can't do anything. God's light is shining upon you, and the devil can't stop it. He's mad, he's angry, but he can't do anything about it. God is just saying, I want you to remain humble, because I want you to know that you are going to continue to walk in your identity in me now, and I'm going to use you for so many different things, for my kingdom and for my glory, my son, my daughter. I'm going to use you for my kingdom and my glory alone. So God is saying to some of you, I'm proud of you. I am proud of you, because you pushed through, and now you see yourself the way I see you, my son, my daughter.